Welcome to an example on solving a quadratic equation by the method of completing the square. To solve a quadratic by completing the square, we'll be following these five steps. Number one, we'll move the constant term to the right side of the equation and also leave room for a special constant that we'll add to both sides. Number two, if the leading coefficient, or a, is not equal to 1, we'll divide everything by a. Number three, to complete the square on the left side, we'll add half of b squared to both sides of the equation, where b would be the coefficient of x after we divide by a if needed. Number three, we'll factor the left side of the equation, which will be a perfect square trinomial, and then we'll take the square root of both sides in order to solve for x. So looking at our example, for the first step, we'll subtract 6 on both sides of the equation. So this would give us 3x. So this would give us 3x squared minus 4x equals negative 6. Notice that a is equal to positive 3, so now we'll divide everything by 3. The leading coefficient must be 1 in order to complete the square. So now we have x squared minus 4/3 x equals, this would be negative 2. And now we're going to add a constant to both sides of the equation to make the left side a perfect square trinomial. So we're going to add half of b squared to both sides of the equation, where b is negative 4/3. So we'll have 1/2 times negative 4/3 squared. So before we square this, notice how this will simplify. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 twos and negative 2. So this simplifies to negative 2/3 squared, which is equal to 4/9. So we're going to add 4/9 to both sides of the equation to make the left side a perfect square trinomial. Now we're going to factor the left side. This is a perfect square trinomial, so we'll have two equal binomial factors. So the factors of x squared are x and x. Now we want the factors of 4/9 that add to negative 4/3. And this is why it's so important to show this work here. The factors we're looking for will always be the value we squared to get the 4/9. Notice we squared negative 2/3 to get 4/9. And therefore, the factors of 4/9 that add to negative 4/3 are negative 2/3 and negative 2/3. Again, this is why it's so important to always show this work here, especially when we're dealing with fractions. Now on the right side, we want to add negative 2 is the same as negative 2 over 1. Common denominator is 9, so we'll multiply negative 2 over 1 by 9 over 9. Notice how this would be denominator of 9. The numerator is going to be negative 18 plus 4, which is negative 14. So now we have negative 14/9 on the right. We can rewrite the left side as the quantity x minus 2/3 squared equals negative 14/9. And now we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation in order to solve for x. Remember, when we do this, to make sure that we obtain both solutions, we need to include a plus or minus sign here. So on the left side, the square root undoes the squaring, so we're left with x minus 2/3 equals, on the right side, we'll take the square root of the numerator and denominator separately. The square root of 9 is equal to 3, and then for the square root of negative 14, since the radicand is negative, we'll have an imaginary number. Square root of negative 14 is equal to negative 1 times 2 times 7. So we don't have any perfect square factors, but the square root of negative 1 is equal to I. So we can write this as I square root 14, or if we want, square root 14i. Let's go ahead and leave the I in the front. So we have I square root 14. So for the last step, we will add 2/3 to both sides of the equation. So we have x equals 2/3. Plus or minus I square root 14 divided by 3. Remember, this represents two solutions. One is x equals 2/3 plus I square root 14 over 3. And the other solution would be x equals 2/3 minus I square root 14 over 3. And again, I do want to point out that sometimes we do see the I written on the right side of this, because complex numbers are normally in the form of a plus or minus bi. So we could write this as x equals 2/3 plus or minus square root 14 divided by 3i, which is equivalent, but some textbooks prefer to have the I to the left of the square root just to make sure that it's not underneath the square root, because if it was, that would be incorrect. I hope you found this helpful.